Hey guys! Today's video is an IPSY video, which I haven't done for a while because I thought I had my subscription like continual, but apparently it was only for a certain amount of time, like maybe 6 months or a year, or I don't know how long. Well, I went on to the website to check and see if I could get signed back up. Well, it showed me my, what does they call it, glam room? I don't know, whatever they call it. Well, I was like, what the heck is this? Well, here it is. I was resubscribed and I didn't know it. So I already knew everything I was getting in my bag, but I still wanted to make a video for you guys. So I figured I would just do an IPSY video, IPSY bag review. I don't know, show you what I got. Hopefully it's interesting. Not as fun as what I usually do because I love the surprising part of it. So I like to be able to be like, oh yeah, what's this? Oh, I was hoping I would get this, or oh, I did not want to get that. So I'm just going to go through my bag and show you guys what I got, and hopefully you guys like it half as much as you like the regular IPSY videos. And next month, I promise there will be a regular surprise IPSY unbagging, okay? So first off, this bag is super cute. When I saw this bag, I was like, this is nice. It's not the regular size of the IPSY bags. It's like, I don't know if I think it's just as wide, but it's taller. And the material, it's so like soft. I love that. Like the other ones are cloth or hard plastic, whatever. But this one, I think, is my favorite out of the bags. Like, what's in it, it's not necessarily my favorite, but the outside of the bag is my favorite. And it has these cute little studs on it, and that just gives a little bit extra sass. And I love how it's the metallic silver gray, whatever you want to call it, leather like, and I like that. So let's get inside. The first thing is this Nourish Organic Moisturizing Cream Face Cleanser, which I can't speak, I don't know, I can't say words. It's cucumber plus watercress. I tried this one time, that's it. It was not that great. Like, I guess my face is hard to get makeup off of. Like, I already used like my regular face wash and then used this because I knew it was not gonna get it, because it's just like a, like, it's kind of like hand soap, not the foamy kind, but like the regular like liquid kind, like you just pump right out of the thing. And the smell is basically like soap. It's not a good smell. It doesn't smell like cucumber or, I don't know, watercress. Maybe it smells like watercress, but it's not a good smell. And that's not why I don't like it. It's just, I'm not really into facial cleansers that are smooth. I like them to have like the little beads in it, or like a microdermabrasion, because since I have such large pores, I like to have that extra little bit of, you know, help to clean my face. So this is okay, not my favorite. I just don't like the texture or the smell. I don't know. I did like the lotion that we got from them, and that it is organic, so that's nice, but other than that, I don't know how I feel about it. The next thing, I am also, like, okay, this whole bag, I'm not gonna lie to you, this video is not gonna be very upbeat, because I think this is one of my least favorite bags that I've gotten. It's just, none of the things in here really are like, wow, I like all this stuff, I really wish I could get a full size of this. There's none of that in here that I liked, you know? So next is this eye pencil from Pacifica. It's natural minerals. It doesn't say the color. It just says 01F4 is the color. No, wait, nope, gunmetal. That's the color. It's right here at the top. It's a cute little pencil size. It's kind of like the one we got a while ago. Is it from Starlux or something? Like the amethyst one. I really like that one because I use it to line my eyes and stuff. But this, I don't know. It's just like a regular gray. It's just like a regular gray eyeliner. There's nothing special about it. It does have a little bit of shimmer to it. I haven't used it yet to see how well it lasts or anything like that, but I mean, I'll use it like if I want to go lighter on my eyeliner or something like that, but it's not something that I want to buy. Like, I love the lotion that I got from them. I did not like the eyeshadows, so maybe they should stick more to lotions and stuff like that instead of beauty products. I don't know, because that shadow I got was not very pigmented or anything like that. I hate to say it, but this is like a bash. I hate being mean, but I want to let you guys know, if you were interested, like you saw somebody else's video, maybe they like them, I don't know, but I just don't like them. The next one is probably my favorite thing out of the bag. It is this Art Touch Tinted Lip Gloss, and it's in Love Affair. It's by Kaylin, I think, because there's so many words. I think it's by Kaylin, and it's Art Touch. like I said, it's in Love Affair. I'm wearing it right now, and as you can tell, it looks nothing like the bottle. Because I saw this bottle, I'm like, oh my god, that is like the brownish red color. That's not gonna look good. But when you open it up, it's way different. Like, it's not the same color as the tube makes it look. Because I don't know if, like, the way the tube is. There's not a lot of product in here because I've used it a couple times and I can already see through it. Like, you can see inside the tube, which, understandable. These are sample sizes. They're deluxe samples or whatever, and sometimes full sizes, but there's not as much stuff in here. Yeah, because, like, when I do that, you can totally see through it already. But, it's a really nice color. And for a gloss and it being a dark color, it works out really nice. Once you get it on, it stays on nicely and it doesn't, like, because you know how sometimes you put dark lip glosses on and, like, as soon as you, like, move your lips, like, a spot's lighter and a spot's darker because it moves around. This, once you get it on how you want it, it pretty much stays where you put it, I guess. I haven't tried eating with it yet or not. But other than that, I really like this lip gloss. I'm going to look it up and see how much it costs because I've never heard of this brand before. But hopefully online they show you swatches of the inside, not the outside, because the outside of this looks nothing like the actual color of the lip gloss. Next we have this Mitchell & Peach English Growers Luxury Hand Cream. It sounds nice. I used it and it makes your hands feel so good. It doesn't really have a smell. It has like a, I guess it would be like a spa smell, like a herbally smell. And I'm more of a fruity person, you guys know that. But the quality is really nice, and it, like I said, it did make my hands really soft, and they didn't feel super oily when I was done putting it on, so that's a good thing. The only put off is the smell, so I probably will continue using this. It is made in England. That's cool. It says, blended with vitamin E, shea butter, and English honey, this nourishing hand cream is fragrant with essential oils from the Mitchell Estate. So it must be like this nice big farm that they grow all their ingredients on, that they make them. So that's really cool. And that makes it even more special because it's not just like made in a factory somewhere. I don't know. I like to have, it feels more natural to me. So that's another thing I got. And the last thing I got was this brush. And this brush is from Crown Brushes. I've never heard of these before either. And it is a shadow and crease brush. I used this earlier today when I did my eye makeup, and I really like it because it has the colors. You can't really see it clear, but like how it has like the fade that goes from the darker to light. I like when the brushes look like that, even though after you use them they get like dirty. But I really do like it. Like, and it's really soft. Like, this end's really nice for the shadow brush. The crease is kind of, I don't know if I'd use it for a crease. It's just like a little round circle. I like my more flat, fluffy but not too big, like this but not as big. I don't know how to explain it, but this just seems too hard. Like, this would be more of like a, you know, liner, or like if you want to do like a, I don't know what you do with it, but it's a nice brush. But I don't think I'll use it for what I want, like what it says to. But I do like this is a really nice fluffy end, and I did use this earlier today. I liked it, and that's all I got. So overall, like I said, this was not my favorite bag. I did like the items a little bit, but they definitely weren't favorites. So hopefully next month when I get surprised, it'll be better. Maybe it's because I knew what I was getting, then it just wasn't exciting, and I just was like, oh, because I was like, I knew what I had. But hopefully next month the surprise bag will be more awesome, exciting, and I will like what they have. I can't wait to see what the theme is, because it's October, so maybe it'll be like Halloween. Like, maybe it'll be bright colors for Halloween stuff. I don't know. Fall. Whatever. So I hope you guys still enjoyed this video, even though it was not my regular IPSY video. I still want to make a video to get back into making them, because like I said, this was my favorite video to film because it was a surprise. And I'm sorry it was such a disappointment. But thumbs up if you want more IPSY videos, because I'm going to be making them anyway. I hope you guys have a great rest of the day. I love you guys. Bye.